Do you post on TikTok only for your video to get no views? Or maybe you get views on TikTok, but those views aren't turning into followers. Either way, this video is gonna teach you how to skyrocket the amount of followers that you're getting on TikTok. In fact, I just created a new TikTok account 24 hours ago and gained over 3,000 followers in just a 24-hour period. And I'm gonna share with you everything that I did in order to make that happen so that you can replicate the same exact results again. This was with a brand new TikTok account, literally with just a few posts. And it only took me about 10 minutes of creating content. I was able to gain over 3,000 followers, and you could do the same exact thing. And if that's not enough, I just helped this creator gain over 25,000 followers on TikTok, this creator over 50,000 followers, and this creator over 100,000 followers. And the only thing that they did different than what you're currently doing right now is they simply follow the blueprint that I'm about to share with you. Step number one to ensure that you get the same results that the three creators that I just shared with you got is making sure that you're actually posting at the right time on TikTok. You see, so many small creators make the mistake of not knowing when to post on TikTok. So I'm about to share with you the three best times to be posting on TikTok right now. But before I could do that, I need you to smash that subscribe button. If you want to grow quicker on TikTok, YouTube, or Instagram, I literally upload a video about how to grow on these platforms every single day. In addition to that, I created a free TikTok growth course that's going to share with you things like what hashtags to use, which we will not have enough time to cover in this video. So please go to the link in the pinned comment below, get into my free TikTok growth course. In addition to that, I quit my job working for Gary Vee in order to help you grow on social media, to help you monetize social media, and ultimately to grow your brand or grow your personal brand on social media. So please shoot me a text message right here. Take advantage of me. I want to help you grow on social media. Now, when it comes to the best time to be posting on TikTok, there are three best times to be posting. The first one is from 11 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. The second one, from 3:30 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. and then the third one from 7:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. Now, of course, this is gonna be somebody in the comments below. They're gonna say something like, Rob, I posted at 6 a.m. and it went viral. Or Rob, I posted at 1 a.m. and it went viral. I'm not interested in that. That was an anomaly. That happened one time. You're not gonna stay up until 1 o'clock in the morning or wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning to make that happen over and over again, because ultimately it's not going to happen over and over again. You got lucky. You posted something good. You probably used the secret principle that I'm gonna share with you later on in this video. And ultimately, that's not replicable. I'm trying to teach you guys the blueprint, the things that you can do over and over and over again to see success on TikTok, to keep growing, to keep getting more views, and to keep being more successful. And that all starts with the time that you're posting. But that's not the only thing you need to be doing. You also need to be doing a few other things, like posting enough content. If you want to be growing on TikTok right now, you need to be posting at least 3 to 4 times a day. Now, I can already hear you guys groaning through the camera. You're saying, Rob, I don't have enough time to post that much. Well, if you don't have enough time to post that much, truly, then at least post 1 to 2 times a day. You guys need to understand something. The more you post on TikTok, the more a few things are gonna happen. Social media is no different than playing basketball, than playing baseball, than being good at math, than being good at anything. The more that you do it, the better you're going to get. But in addition to that, the more times you post on social media, a few things happen. One, you're able to find video topics that resonate with your audience. Two, you're able to have more viral videos. Three, you give TikTok more videos. The worst thing that could possibly happen is your first video goes viral. The reason you don't want that to happen is because then TikTok has no other videos to suggest to your audience. Let me give you an example. If you create a piece of content and it's your 10th piece of content and that video goes viral, or that video gets you more followers, or that video does really well, well then guess what's going to happen with the 9 other pieces of content that you made in the past? TikTok is then going to push out those pieces of content, which again is why you don't want your first post on TikTok to go viral. Now, I need you to also understand something. If you post one piece of content a day, you might get a little bit of followers. If you post 2, you're gonna get more followers. 3, you're going to get more followers. 4, you're going to get more followers. And I always provide an example of this with specific niches, and then I get a ton of comments below that say, Rob, but what about this niche? What about this niche? So I'm gonna give you guys an example right now that it doesn't matter what niche you're in. Let's say that you post a video about apples. Everybody that likes apples then follows you, but your competitor posted a video about apples, posted a video about oranges, posted a video about blueberries, and posted a video about raspberries. And then everybody that was into all 4 of those fruits followed them. Who gained more followers? You're right, your competitor did. And this is a huge mistake that so many of you guys do not understand. Whether you're selling something, you're trying to get people to follow you, you're just trying to relate to people, you need to be putting out more pieces of content to actually be able to do that. And in some cases, this is gonna mean that not every one of your videos is gonna go viral, or not every one of your videos is gonna get a ton of views. But that's fine, because you're going to find the videos that get more views, the videos that relate to more people, and ultimately, it's going to help you grow quicker on TikTok. But again, that's not it. There's one other secret thing that I need to share with you in just a second. But before I do that, I want to share with you how you can actually know how many views your video is going to get, or be able to predict how successful your post is going to be before you even post. But first, I need to make sure you understand something. This opportunity to grow on TikTok that we're seeing right now, where you can literally gain tens of thousands of followers, 100,000 followers in a really short period of time, and for a lot of you, millions of followers in just 30 days, 60 days, 90 days, half a year. This incredible opportunity, it's not going to last forever. More and more brands are coming onto TikTok. The secret's out that TikTok is the best social media platform to be on besides YouTube Shorts or Instagram Reels right now. And so many people are diving into it. So you need to make sure that you're actually taking this opportunity seriously, and that you please implement the next two things I'm going to share with you, because they're going to make all the difference in whether or not you blow up on TikTok. Now, the way that you're going to do that is actually searching for the topic that you're about to post about, whatever you're about to post about. Search for it. Then I want you to filter for this month. I want you to filter for most liked. And if there aren't videos under there with more than 10,000 likes, the odds of your video getting over 100,000 views is slim to none. So the video is probably not going to do well if it doesn't have a good audience behind it. Now, this always opens the question, Rob, if my topic that I thought I was going to post about is not going to do well, then what on earth should I be posting about? I'm glad you asked. What I would suggest you post about right now are, one, topics that you search for in your niche that have a large audience, the example that I just shared with you. Or what you need to be doing, look at the small creators in your niche. So many people make the mistake of looking at the big creators in their niche, seeing what posts they did that did well. Do not do that. Do not compare yourself to them unless you're another big creator. Instead, look at the small to medium-sized creators in your niche, see what they're posting about that is getting them more views than they have followers. And what this means is, one, it's a really easy video topic to create, and it's something you can also create and get a lot of views. Two, this is going to help you determine what hooks are actually working, what lengths of content are working, and ultimately, what content ideas are getting pushed out in the algorithm right now, because I need you to understand something. Just because a competitor posted about something doesn't mean that you shouldn't post about it. In fact, it means that you should post about it, because odds are you're going to get more views than they did, because TikTok knows that they have an audience for that content, plus your followers or anybody else that might interact with it might increase the size of that audience, and that is how videos go viral on TikTok, and that is what's going to make you successful. But you can't stop there. I see so many creators every single day that get a lot of views on their videos, especially small creators, but they forgot to do one other thing, which decreases the amount of followers that they get, and you do not want to make this mistake. Like I said, I literally look at hundreds of TikTok accounts every single day, and when I see a small creator mess up like this, it makes me want to slam my head through a wall. If at least 15% of people that like your content are not following you, you're making a huge mistake, and that mistake is that you don't have a call to action in your content. You need a call to action in two places. First, in the last 3 seconds of your video, or in the beginning of your video, right after the hook, if it's going to be a long piece of content. And the second place you need it is in the description. I get DMs all the time. I get comments all the time. Rob, but some people say if you ask people to follow, nobody's going to watch the video. Couldn't be further from the truth. If you ask them straight up for a follow for absolutely no reason, of course, nobody's going to watch that video. So make sure you're providing them some kind of value. Make sure you're giving them a really good reason for them actually following you. And that is what's going to make that more successful. Now, if you want me to guarantee that you get more followers on TikTok in the next 30 days by me telling you exactly what to post, what time to post, what hashtags to use to guarantee that you grow, like all the examples that you saw in this video, then you need to keep watching this video. The opportunity to grow on TikTok and this organic reach is not going to last forever. And the only thing separating you from the creators that I mentioned in this video is, one, that you haven't implemented the steps from this video yet, and two, you haven't gotten into my mentorship program where I literally guarantee that I can help you grow on TikTok. If you register for this program, I'm going to tell you exactly what to post, when to post, what hashtags to use, and I'm going to critique your content for 30 days in order to guarantee that you grow on TikTok. You heard that right. If you don't grow on TikTok in this program, you get your money back, zero questions asked. The average person that has joined the program in the last 30 days gained over 50,000 followers, and the lowest amount of followers anybody has ever gained in their program is 6,500 followers. If you want results like that, and I'm guessing that since you're still watching this video, you're probably above average, so you probably see more than 50,000 followers in just 30 days, no matter what niche you're in, no matter what background you're from, none of that stuff matters. The only thing that matters is you need a social media coach. You need somebody telling you what to post, when to post, what hashtags to use, so that you get results faster and you get results a lot easier. If that sounds interesting, go to the link in the description below. There are limited spots available, and the price is going to be going up in 2022, so please make sure you check this out. This is the same exact program Joel Magician used to gain over 16 million followers, that AvMoves used to gain over 14 million followers, that Tuvok used to gain over 10 million followers, and thousands of other creators. I'm telling you guys, this opportunity is not going to last forever. If you want to take advantage of TikTok, you need to invest in, I'm telling you guys, this opportunity is not going to last forever. If you want to take advantage of TikTok, you need to invest in this before the price goes up, before there are no spots available, so that you can guarantee that you grow on TikTok. At the end of the day, you have absolutely nothing to lose. You're either going to grow on TikTok, or you are going to get your money back, zero questions asked. Go to the link in the description and and sign up right now before spots run out. And by the way, if you're not interested in that, just check out the two videos I'm gonna put up on the screen because they're the videos that YouTube thinks you should watch next. Thank you so much for watching.